يا كريم يا رب العالمين. يا رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإن ربك لذو فضل على وإن ربك لذو فضل على الناس ولكن أكثرهم لا يشكرون. وإن ربك ليعلم ما تكن صدورهم وما يعلنون. وما من غائبة في السماء والأرض إلا في كتاب مبين. إن هذا القرآن يقص على بني إسرائيل أكثر الذي هم فيه يختلفون. إن هذا القرآن يقص على بني إسرائيل أكثر الذي هم فيه يختلفون. وإنه لهدى ورحمة وإنه لهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين. إن ربك يقضي بينهم بحكمه وهو العزيز العليم. إن ربك هو يقضي بينهم بحكمه وهو العزيز العليم. فتوكل على الله إن ربك يقضي بينهم بحكمه إن ربك يقضي بينهم بحكمه وهو العزيز العليم. فتوكل على الله كلا على الله إنك على الحق المبين. إنك لا تسمع الموتى ولا تسمع الصم الدعاء ولا تسمع الصم الدعاء إذا ولوا مدبرين. وما أنت بهاد العمي عن ضلالتهم إن تسمع إلا من يؤمن بآياتنا فهم مسلمون. وَإِذَا وَقَعَ الْقَوْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَخْرَجْنَا لَهُمْ دَابَّةً مِنَ الْأَرْضِ تُكَلِّمُهُمْ أخرجنا لهم دابة من الأرض تكلمهم إن الناس سكانوا بآياتنا لا يوقنون ويوم نحشر من كل أمة فوجا ممن يكذب بآياتنا فهم يوزعون حتى إذا جاءوا قال أكذبتم بآياتي ولم تحيطوا بها علما أماذا كنتم تعملون ووقع القول عليهم بما ظلموا فهم لا ينطقون ووقع القول عليهم بما ظلموا فهم لا ينطقون ألم يروا أنا جعلنا الليل ليسكنوا فيه ألم يروا أنا جعلنا الليل ليسكنوا فيه والنهار مبصرا ألم يروا أنا جعلنا الليل ليسكنوا فيه والنهار مبصرا إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يؤمنون ويوم ففزع من في السماوات ومن في الأرض إلا من شاء الله وكل فأتوه داخرين. وكل آتوه داخرين. وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة وهي تمر مر السحاب وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة وهي تمر مر السحاب صنع الله صنع أتقن كل شيء إنه خبير بما يفعلون من جاء بالحسنة فله خير منها من جاء بالحسنة فله خير منها فله خير منها وهم من فزع يومئذ آمنون ومن جاء بالسيئة فكبت وجوههم في النار هل تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إنما أمرت أن أعبد رب هذه البلدة الذي حرمها وله كل شيء وأمرت أن أكون من المسلمين وأن أتلو القرآن فمن اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه ومن ضل فقل إنما أنا من المنذرين وقل الحمد لله سيريكم آياته فتعرفونها وما ربك بغافل عما يعملون صدق الله العظيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمدك يا مولانا حمدا كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقائدنا وأستاذنا ومعلمنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله الطاهرين وصحابته الميامين وعلى كل من اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة أولاً بتقوى الله سبحانه. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال عز من قائل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة، أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. جعلني الله وإياكم من عباده المتقين الفائزين الذاكرين، آمين اللهم آمين. O you who believe, do not let death approach you except in the state of taqwa, in the state of piety and righteousness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those whom live and die upon piety and righteousness. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. Beloved brothers and respected sisters, When Fir'aun gathered the masses and called upon the magicians to expose and to embarrass Musa alayhi salam, the magicians were called. They all came together. The people of Egypt came together. A day of defeating Musa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala documents the story of Musa in many chapters in the Quran. A movie that you can watch, that which you can envision. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala documents in the Quran and records in the Quran that Musa alayhi salam said, "Alqu ma antum mulqun." Throw whatever you want to throw. Do whatever you want to do. فَأَلْقَوْ حِبَالَهُمْ وَعِصِيَّهُمْ وَقَالُوا بِعِزَّةِ فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّا لَنَحْنُ الْغَالِبُونَ. They then threw their ropes, threw their sticks, and then swore by the honor of Fir'aun that they will be victorious. Arrogance. Going against Allah, going against the Prophet of Allah, Musa alayhi salam. And it turned all into snakes. At that moment, Musa alayhi salam was shook. Musa alayhi salam was struck with some fear. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala empowered Musa alayhi salam and reminded Musa alayhi salam to remain firm and strong. قُلْنَا لَا تَخَفْ. Don't be afraid. Don't get scared. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْأَعْلَى. You will have the upper hand. But Musa alayhi salam was still scared. Musa alayhi salam then is given clear instructions to throw his stick. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his power and his might, turns the stick into a snake. A miracle that was performed by Musa alayhi salam through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Musa threw the stick and the magicians realized that what Musa just did and what was performed is a clear miracle from Allah, immediately bowed down and prostrated to Allah as Allah mentions. They all performed sujood. فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سَاجِدِينَ قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ رَبِّ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ. They all engaged in sujood and they all declared their faith, that they've embraced the faith of Musa and Harun. SubhanAllah, within moments, these people were gathered to destroy Musa, to destroy his message. And the same people that were called to achieve that goal became the greatest supporters of Musa alayhi salam. This is what happens when one relies on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person does what he or she have to do, but their reliance is completely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allow Allah to facilitate the means. People that have stood against you, people that have plotted against you, people that have spoken against you, people that have wanted to do you wrong, cheat you in their businesses, and you tried, but you do that with certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will facilitate your affairs. Allah will take care of it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not assist Musa by sending down angels. Ya Musa, here are the angels. Under your command, Allah allowed his enemies to be his closest alliances. His closest alliance. His greatest supporters. To the extent where threats were thrown out there in public. لَأُقَطَّعَنَّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ مِنْ خِلَافٍ. Threats of being beheaded, limbs being amputated, and their response to Fir'aun, لَن نُؤْثِرَكَ عَلَى مَا جَاءَنَا مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالَّذِي فَطَرَنَا. We will never compromise our faith. We will never give up that which is dear. فَقْضِ مَا أَنْتَ قَالَ. Do whatever you want to do. You can only maybe rule out what happens here. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of our affair. SubhanAllah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes in. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intervenes and brings about change through that source which you may have considered to be harmful. The same person that declared his animosity, his hatred towards you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows that person to be your greatest advocate in the hands of Allah. And also in the example of Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun, someone that has dedicated his life to enslave people, to kill children, and began to execute that plan. And Musa alayhi salam was the one whom he feared. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not only bring success to Musa over Fir'aun, He allows Fir'aun to be the murabbi, his caretaker. He provided his own enemy, whom he feared, with water, with shelter, with love, with care, and the list goes on. Why? Because Allah facilitated his affair. Allah has promised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of it. We do our part, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala works in ways you and I can never imagine. Only comes with tawakkul, only comes with trust, only comes with understanding who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. And Fir'aun raises Musa alayhi salam to be the strong man he was. Musa alayhi salam was able to stand against the Pharaoh. He was able to convey his message. And he handled himself strongly alayhi salam with Fir'aun's threats. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took care of him. The one whom he feared was the one whom he raised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took care of the means. And you find it in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam with many examples that we find in our tradition. One of them is Suraqa ibn Malik, the one whom was chasing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and wanted to receive the grand prize of 100 red camels per head, the Prophet's head and Abu Bakr's head, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa radiyallahu an Abi Bakr. 100, 200 camels. And he arrives and he gets to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet communicates with Suraqa ibn Malik and he says, "What will you do wearing the jewelry of the Persian emperor?" Suraqa is surprised by that comment and then believes in the promise. People then look for Suraqa and they find Suraqa. "Did you find these two men?" The same person that came looking for the grand prize to expose the Prophet, to take him back to Mecca, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is assassinated and killed, was the man that defended the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he did not tell the people where the Prophet was heading, did not give him the secret place. And he just moved on with his life, where Suraqa bin Malik radiallahu anhu became a sahabi, and the Prophet's promise was fulfilled. SubhanAllah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes things. He controls, brothers and sisters, the hearts, the minds. He controls one's actions of how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects, how directions are immediately changed because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intervenes. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does with plots, where we find in the Quran that Allah is the best of those whom plot, is that He exposes the plot. And He brings about clarity and He allows you and I to navigate with success. Surat al-Buruj that you find in the last Juz Amma, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about that young child as he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam elaborates on the surah, where that young man that was calling people to Allah and the king was threatened by his call. And he promised to kill that young man that was calling people to Allah, and he tries to kill that young man in different ways. He sends him up to the mountain, wanting to throw him down, wanting to drown him, and nothing works out. And that young man then says, "If you want to kill me, set the arrow to my heart and hang me on a tree. And the condition is that you say, in the name of the Lord, in the name of this young man's Lord, Bismillah Rabbil Ghulam. In the name of his Lord, this young man is Lord." He says, "Once you say that, you'll get me." And this man was so desperate. This king was so desperate, did not want people to be moved by this young man that was calling them to Allah, causing disturbance, changing people's faith, From being connected to this king to being connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the king thinks that now this is a sign of success. It is time to kill this young child. And he prepares himself and he shouts out loud, Bismillah, Rabbil Ghulam. And that young man is killed. And the moment he does that, everyone shouts out, Amanna bi Rabbil Ghulam. We've believed in the Lord of this young man. Subhanallah, he's been calling people to Allah for years and years and did not see any fruits of his call, did not see the change until this king, this oppressive king that wanted to kill the da'wah, was the greatest advocate. And if it wasn't for that incident, he would have continued to face struggles. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intervened and allowed this man, this king, to be the greatest da'iyah, caller to Allah, where people embraced their faith and firmly accepted Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that when the trench was, they were digging the trench and the fire began, they still did not compromise. Shows you how strong that da'wah was because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala facilitated that young man's affair. قُلُوا قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا فَيَفَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرُونَ. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله الطاهرين وبعد. ابن القيم عليه رحمة الله says some wise teachings, beautiful lines. He says, لما تولى الله أمر يوسف أحوج الناس إلى الماء تلك القافلة فذهبوا لشرب الماء فاستخرجوا منها يوسف عليه السلام ثم أحوج الوزير العزيز إلى الأبناء فذهب إلى السوق بحثا عنهم فوجد يوسف عليه السلام قال ثم أحوج الملك إلى تفسير الرؤيا فبحث عن يوسف عليه السلام فأخرجه من السجن قال ثم أحوج مصر بكلها إلى الطعام والشراب فأصبح بذلك عزيز مصر. ابن القيم عليه رحمة الله, he says that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to protect Yusuf, he allowed the caravan to experience some thirst, which then led them to the well, where Yusuf alayhi salam was found in the well. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised to protect him. And then Yusuf alayhi salam was enslaved by that caravan, taken all the way to Egypt. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed the prime minister of Egypt to feel this dire need to adopt a young child. He was not looking for a worker. He was not looking for a slave. He was looking for a child to carry on, to work, to assist him in his mission. To find himself in the market and to find this beautiful child, Yusuf alayhi salam, and he adopts Yusuf. Yusuf enters prison, thinking it's the end of it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows the king to see this dream, where in dire need, he begins to search for any interpreter to interpret his dream, to find Yusuf alayhi salam in front of him interpreting that dream. And he allowed the people of Egypt to experience this urgency of solving this future crisis of famine and thirst, the whole country, to find Yusuf alayhi salam solving that problem where he became one of its prime ministers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala solved his affair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in his own way, was there for Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. Even in Surah Al-Kahf, as you and I recite Surah Al-Kahf on Fridays, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the people of Kahf to the extent where Allah says, وَنُقَلِّبُهُمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ وَذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. In the cave, sleeping for over 30 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the bodies to move right and left to preserve the body, to allow the blood flow. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took that upon himself because he has promised to preserve those individuals. Not only the miracle happened, daily intervention of how the sun will rise and how the sun will set and how much sunlight they will get, and the dog placed in the door of the cave, the opening of the cave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised. And what this does, brothers and sisters, as we begin this new year, so many challenges happen. And people that may go against you, and people that may talk against you. We try our best, but we must train ourselves to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. This is what we get from tafweel. Complete reliance on Allah is to go and seek the means. But in that moment of urgency where a person is desperate, they sit by themselves and they call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It always begins, Ya Allah, and not Ya Fulan. I have enough attorneys, I have enough friends, I have strong connections, we have Allah. This is our first step towards change, towards overcome whatever struggle it is that I say, Ya Allah. Oh Allah, bring about that relief. Oh Allah, bring about that success. Oh Allah, allow me to overcome this burden that I feel on my shoulders. Oh Allah, facilitate my affairs. Oh Allah, take care of the means. And then we go about our work. And this is where someone begins to experience the concept of tawakkul, reliance on Allah, trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a person begins to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything they may do, even if it may not go the way they want it to go. But they see the wisdom behind that rejection. Even if it, to them it was something negative, but they see divine wisdom in rejecting that dua or not allowing it to happen, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of planners. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to facilitate our affairs. We ask Allah to bless us with this certainty, with this yaqeen, with this iman that we need in order for us to navigate through these challenges. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring ease to these challenges and allow the means that have brought some difficulty to be the means to our success. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. Ala wa sallu wa sallimu ala man ba'athahu Allahu rahmatan lil alameen haythu umirtum bis salati wa salam عليه. فقال عز من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم فصلي وسلم وزد وبارك عليه وعلى آله الأطهار وصحابته الأخيار وعلى كل من اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته واختفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وعلي فضلك راية الحق والدين. انصر عبادك المؤمنين المستضعفين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين، كلهم حافظا وناصرا ومؤيدا ومعينا، احرسهم بعينك التي لا تنام. اغفر المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا